What's up, Rissa gang? I'm back with another video, and as y'all can tell by the title, I am doing a DIY video, and today I'm going to be ripping these jeans up because, as y'all see, this is before. They look a little plain stale right now, so I'm gonna make them look good for you. So what I'm gonna start by doing is cutting off the ends of these pants because, well, I don't really have a idea what I was gonna do to these jeans, but I knew I wanted to do something crazy. So I'm cutting out the ends, then I'm gonna make the ends fuzzy and cut them up and stuff. Y'all see. And these are the tools I use, by the way. It's a cheese grater and a zester or a peeler, I believe. Those are the tools that I use to make the jeans distressed, I guess y'all would say. Now, cutting the ends like I am doing now is optional. I'm only doing this to give it like more volume, I guess I could say, because I want the fuzziness to be seen from like a mile away. So that's why I'm doing this, but you don't have to. So now I'm about to go on my cheese grater. Oh, I already have. But the cheese grater, I like to use it to prep the area that I'm going to rip and stuff. I use it to like loosen the area up. Then I go in with the zester. And that's what really does the work. Yeah, that right there. That does the work. The peeler, that is loosening it up for you. That just preps it. But the zester is what finishes it. So yeah, y'all can do this to y'all liking or y'all preference of like how much distress y'all want it to be. I'm doing it a lot because I like to have a really dramatic look. And yeah. Oh, by the way, if y'all have any questions, feel free to let me know because I will answer them for you. So now I am about to make my first cut, and what I do, I like to measure it, make sure it's straight first, the line is straight, then I just like to make a little tiny cut of where I want my cuts to be, and then like now I'm just gonna cut them however long you want, and I want them to go all the way across the ankle, so that's what I'm doing, and I'm just making sure they're all the same length. This is optional, but I just like to use my leg, well, my knee when I be doing this. It just makes it easier because it's hard to do it while it's on the floor or just me holding it. So this makes it easier for me, but it might be different for you. So now what I'm about to do is, well, y'all know how pants, they be having that white stuff. It's not really a hole. It just be the white thread be there. That's what I'm about to do here. In order to do that, because I know y'all can't really see that good. But really, I just made another cut like I did at the bottom. And I'm using tweezers to pull out the blue thread. And I'm leaving a white thread there. And you got to be extra careful when you're doing that. Also, because you don't want to break the white thread. So now we're outside and y'all can see I got the pants on a chair with some bags, and now we're about to get into the bleaching process. And by the way, don't mind all that paint that I'm showing right now. I was gonna put paint, like splattered paint on them, but then I changed my mind. So when I first started putting the bleach on the pants, I thought I was going to put them all over the pants, but then I decided to just put the bleach on the cuts because I thought that would be cool. They would be lighter than the rest of the pants. So now, this is when I brought them in the house because they were sitting outside drying, and this is them when they're fully dry. I just wanted to show y'all how the bleach turned out, and it's going to look even better after I wash them. So that's what I'm doing now. I'm putting them in the washing machine. So now I'm taking the jeans out, and can we just take a moment to look at how good they came out? Like, look how much volume the washing machine added to the rips, and look how bright it made the bleach look. I did not think that bleach was gonna come out that good, but it did. So now I'm putting them in a dryer. I'm not gonna dry them completely dry because I don't want the jeans to shrink. So I'm only going to dry them for 10 minutes, and then after that, I will let them air dry. So we have reached the final look, finally. And yeah, comment down below how y'all think these came out. I think they came out really good because I mean, I do this, so of course. But yeah, tell me what y'all like about it, what y'all don't like. Well, no, don't send me down, I don't really care. But yeah, oh yeah, and don't mind the recording because my niece from my last video, she was recording this and she was all over the place. So yeah, sorry about that. But yeah, tell me how y'all like these jeans. And yeah, subscribe and comment, like and all that. And I'll see y'all in my next video. Bye.
Shut some drinking.